Hello, everyone, and welcome to Travel Picks. I am Chad Freeman, and today we're going to talk about the top five DSLR cameras of 2018. So, not saying you have to buy one of these if you're getting into photography, but we definitely think these are the best options for 2018 on the prosumer level. So, let's jump into it. Every time I close my eyes, it's like a dark paradise. No one compares to you. All right, guys, coming in at number five is the Canon 5DSR. This thing's featuring 50 megapixel CMOS sensor, huge megapixel, 5 FPS continuous shooting. ISO is from 100 to 6400, that extends to 12,800. Has a 61 point autofocus module with input from 150K pixel metering sensor. It's featuring dual digit 6 processors, 3.0, 1.04 M.LCD, CF and SD card slots, UHS, I compatible, 1080 30p video. Now, guys, the reason this is number five is because we do feel like it's a little pricey for what it is, especially when you can spend $3,500 on some of our top cameras. This is why this camera comes in at number five. Still a great choice, but I would definitely say this is a number five camera. All right, coming in at number four is the Nikon D810. This thing features a 36.3 megapixel full-frame CMOS sensor, no anti-aliasing filter though. ISO 64-12800 expands to ISO 32/51200, electronic first curtain shutter, and redesigned mirror mechanism. The new RAW size S, 9MP RAW mode, X-Speed 4 engine. Features max 5 FPS shooting in FX mode, 7 FPS in DX with battery grip, ENEL18/AA batteries, 3.2-inch 1.229 K-dot RGBW LCD screen with customizable color OLED viewfinder information display. Does have 91,000 pixel RGB metering sensor for advanced subject tracking and metering, and improved scene recognition system allows face detection in OVF mode. Does have split screen zoom display and live view, allows horizontal lines to be leveled precisely. It's got a 51 point autofocus system with new group area AF mode inherited from D4S, with a new flat picture control mode for massive dynamic range capture video focus. Now, obviously the Nikon D810 is an amazing camera. It's a little older camera, but the bigger brother now, which is the Nikon D850, is also a beast. But the Nikon D810, if you want to spend a little less money than its bigger brother, I would definitely go with number four. Now, coming in at number three is the Canon 5D Mark IV. Now, this camera's been out just for a little bit. Great camera. A lot of people like this. Very popular camera. For the price, you know, definitely there, in our opinion, is obviously some better options out there considering it is number three. But this thing features 30.4 megapixel full-frame CMOS sensor, 7 FPS continuous shooting and silent shutter mode, has 4K 30 frames per second video with 8.8 megapixel still frame grab, full 1080p HD 60 FPS and HD 720p mode at 120 FPS. Dual pixel CMOS autofocus for responsive and smooth autofocus during video or live view shooting. Dual pixel RAW, built-in Wi-Fi NFC, 3.2, 81.1 millimeter, approximately 1,620,000 dot Clearview 2 LCD monitor with full touchscreen interface, including selection of autofocus area. Has a Digic 6 image processor, 61 point high density reticular autofocus 2 system, like the 1DX Mark II, including up to 41 cross type autofocus sensors with EOS ITR F8 autofocus. So, guys, this camera is an amazing camera. I mean, a lot of people use it. A lot of people love it. It's really good for photography, and we all know that Canon's picture profiles and color profiles are extremely good. So I don't think you can go wrong with number three. Just pay attention to the price, especially considering that there are two other cameras on our list. And coming in at number two for good reason, and one of my favorite cameras, is the Sony A7 R3. Now, this camera is basically the big brother or big sister of the Sony A7 R2, which many said was one of the best photography cameras in the world. Obviously, the mirrorless line of cameras, and a lot of people absolutely love these, and for good reason. Features 2.4 megapixel, 35mm, full-frame Exmor R CMOS and enhanced processing system. Standard ISO 100-32000 with an upper range. Has fast hybrid autofocus with 399.4 focal plane phase detection autofocus, and 425 point contrast detection autofocus. High speed continuous shooting of up to 10 FPS, 12 with autofocus AE tracking, 5 axis image stabilization with 5.5 stop exposure, does take Sony E-mount lenses, 35mm full frame, Exmor CMOS sensor, approximately 42.4 megapixels. So I truly believe that you don't need too many more megapixels than that unless you're really going to do crazy prints or be printing for some magazine. ISO 100-32000, expandable to ISO 50-102400, auto ISO 100-12800, selectable lower limit and upper limit. Movies are ISO 100-32000 equivalent, auto ISO 100-12800. Approximately 530 shots viewfinder and approximately 650 shots LCD monitor. So guys, like I said, this is definitely one of the top cameras in the world. There are only a couple little small reasons why it did not get our top shot. I believe that this camera is not quite as good personally at video as, say, our number one choice. And you know, there's just some other issues that, you know, considering it is a mirrorless camera, there are some drawbacks. I personally don't like the actual navigation as much as I do our number one choice. So, but I will say, if you are a professional photographer, or if you were going to shoot a cover of a magazine or whatever the case is, the Sony A7 R3 would be fine. And I think the price is fair for considering what you're getting. And just keeping in mind that, you know, Sony lenses do work the best on these cameras. I know they do have some adapters so you can use other lenses, but sometimes the autofocuses and all that stuff just don't seem to work out as good. Unless you have the Sony lenses. So anyways, number two is an amazing choice. It's the Sony A7 R3. And guys, all of these links for all the cameras are in the description below, so check them out. And coming in at number one is the Nikon D850. Now this camera is an absolute beast of a camera. It does replace the Nikon D810. There are many reasons why this camera is number one, but it is just, it's amazing. Let's read some of the specs. So this is a Nikon design backside illuminated BSI full frame image sensor with no optical low pass filter. Features a 45.7 megapixel of extraordinary resolution, outstanding dynamic range, and virtually no risk of MOIR, up to 9 FPS 1 continuous shooting at full resolution with full autofocus performance, 8K 6 and 4K time lapse movies with new levels of sharpness and detail, tilting touchscreen, focus shift shooting mode, outstanding battery performance, and much more. Has 4K Ultra HD video recording, slow motion up to 120 FPS at 1080p, the lowest base ISO of ISO 64 of any DSLR or mirrorless camera. This thing was introduced in August of 2017 and replaces the Nikon D810. The only cons that we really see with this camera is there is no image stabilization, and it does have quite a heavy body. But honestly, if you are looking to get into travel photography, travel video, or if you're just looking to be a professional photographer or are a professional photographer, if you want to, and definitely want to upgrade to something that is worth it, I would definitely say the Nikon D850 is the camera to go with. Now, as you can see, a lot of these cameras in our top five list are similar to price. You know, there are some cameras out there like the Sony A7 R2 that are going to be a little cheaper now. And some of the, you know, maybe one or two cameras on our list may be a little cheaper than this one. But guys, you get what you pay for. I mean, if you want to take this on professionally, you want to be able to shoot the best pictures in the world. The Nikon D850, there's no way that you can't say that, you know, you can't do what you need to do. This camera is all that it is cracked up to be. I believe that within the next 6-7 months, I think more and more photographers are going to catch on to this camera. And we're going to start seeing a lot more hands-on reviews. We're actually going to do a review of this camera ourselves on this channel, so be sure to stay tuned to that. And again, all the links for any of these cameras are down below in the description, so be sure to check that out if you are interested in purchasing any of these cameras. And that wraps up our top five, guys. Alright guys, as you can see, that was the top 5 cameras of 2018. Now, I'm not saying that you have to buy one of those cameras if you want to get into photography, but if you're looking to take your photography or your videography to the next level and you want to try this professionally, I would definitely recommend any one of those cameras are going to do amazing things for you in the future. Be sure to comment below. Let me know what you use, if you use any of these cameras, and what your thoughts are on our top 5 list. Guys, be sure to like and subscribe. More videos to come. Thank you for watching.